Good morning. I am Larry Hawley for WGN News Now. We are right now carrying the live news conference to announce a franchise here in Chicago for Major League Rugby. It's being held in downtown Chicago as details about this new team are announced. Let's go ahead and get you right out to that news conference right now.
We will build a Major League Rugby team that Chicagoans can be proud of. I'd like to proudly introduce you to Chicago Hounds Rugby. The Hound, our Hound's head embodies the spirit of Chicago with strength, guts, and ferocity. The six-pointed star pays homage to the Chicago flag and our city's storied history. The green, white, and blue stand proudly for our Chicago and our Irish roots, and the blue converging lines are inspired by the Chicago River merge you see behind you today. I'd like to introduce you to our head coach, Sam Harris.
Thanks, mate. Thanks, guys. Great to be here. I'm a little bit of a storyteller, so I'll probably be a little less formal. As a kid growing up in Sydney, Australia, I wore three of my VCR tapes out when I was watching them, and they were Jordan's Playground, Untouchables, and Three-Peat. I couldn't watch enough of it. So as a kid, I loved Chicago. I loved Michael Jordan. And yeah, now as a coach, I loved what Phil Jackson was able to achieve with the Bulls. Also, you know, I loved American sports when I was a kid. Played baseball from like 8 to 16. Frank Thomas was my favorite player. You know, another great person from Chicago. And then another little story from when I was playing for the Australian schoolboys against the All Black schoolboys the night before the game, our coach showed us a video of Dick Butkus just to get us hyped and to get us ready for the game. And so, you know, I think as a kid, Chicago's always been on my radar, and I've always loved Chicago as a city. And it's great to finally be here. And it's not lost on me the honour of being able to be the head coach that leads this great team into the MLR. Got two main objectives of the coach, as the coach, and they are success, obviously, but what does success look like? Rugby World Cup comes here in 2031 to this great country, and when everybody's coming from around the world, everyone knows who the Chicago Hounds are, because through that 9-year period, we would have had the most success, and we would have been the most consistent team in the MLR. And then the second objective for me is, we will have some good foreign talent that will add to this group. But this team will be about American talent and growing American talent. We'll find them, we'll acknowledge where they are, and then we will develop them, and then we'll expose them to high level rugby. And what I want is for the USA Eagles, when they've got a team, you can see Chicago Hounds all over that team, and we're the most well-represented team in the American Eagles. So it is a great honor to be here in Chicago, and I thank the ownership group and James for selecting me to be this person, and I'm looking forward to the future of Chicago Hounds and MLR rugby. Thank you very much.
Bryce Campbell here, USA Eagle number 497. Could not be more excited to tell you I'm joining the Chicago Hounds this season. Being born and raised in the Midwest, it's really special to me to bring professional rugby to the region. I just can't wait to get to Chicago. Up the Hounds.
Thanks, Bryce. And we'd like to welcome George Killebrew to come and say a few words.
Long way here, excuse me. Well, first of all, you know, on behalf of the Board of Governors of Major League Rugby, we'd like to welcome our newest member, the Chicago Hounds. Gentlemen, welcome to the club. Let's give him a big round of applause. It is a great time for rugby in North America. I don't need to tell this room that. With the World Cup coming in 2031 for the men and 2033 for the women, it gives a great runway now for Major League Rugby, an 8 to 9 year pathway to really try to get it right here in North America, and we intend to do that. If you think about it, you know, we're a 12-team league, but if we added one or two teams on that pathway to World Cup, you know, we'll be a 28-team league by the time the World Cup gets here. If you remember, when soccer brought their World Cup to the United States for the first time, there was no professional league. The idea was to bring the game, introduce it to the American fans, and a professional league would be born, which is exactly what happened in Major League Soccer 29 years ago. So as we turn 6 years old, Major League Rugby is a really interesting and good growth story in sports in this country. You know, it started, for those of you that aren't familiar, it started with seven teams 6 years ago, grew to nine, grew to 12. We played with 13 in the competition last year. We're adding Chicago for the 2023 competition. We have another announcement coming up. I'll tease it a little bit for an additional team that will join in 2023 but not compete until 2024. So I think what's happening in North America are people are realizing this sport has arrived and it's really starting to grow and take off. And with that North Star, if you will, of the World Cup coming in 2031, it's a really great pathway for MLR to pay attention to and really take the growth steps necessary that when World Cup does arrive in the United States and in North America that we're ready for it. So it's a great time to be here. What does it mean for MLR? You know, a little bit about kind of us if you're not familiar. Like I said, it's been a great growth story. We're in all the major metropolitan areas now. We're in the top 10 as measured by Nielsen, except for two cities. So we're in eight of the top 10 now that we've added Chicago. The only two we are not in of the top 10 cities in the country are San Francisco and Philadelphia, the top 10 Nielsen markets. So, you know, expansion, those types of cities are definitely on our minds all the time. We will not expand rapidly. We will look to add a team or two on this pathway to World Cup, make sure we get the right partners, have the right stadium situation, which, you know, to back up a little bit, we've been talking in Chicago for 3 years, trying to find the right group of investors, trying to find the right stadium situation. And by the way, your stadium situation is as good as anyone in our league today. So congratulations, that's a world-class facility you're gonna be playing in. A little bit about television, which kind of runs sports these days. We'll be doing 25 games in partnership with Fox. We will do most of them on FS2. We will probably do 7 to 8 on FS1, which is a 20 million delta in households when you get elevated from FS2 to FS1. And we will do the finals on Fox Broadcast Corp, FBC, or as I like to call it, Big Fox, when we get to the finals. And who knows, maybe an expansion team finds its way to the finals. That'd be kind of interesting, huh? We also own and operate something called the Rugby Network. How many of you are familiar with the Rugby Network? Okay, good. So that's our OTT platform. It's free. It's all you got to do is go on. It's www.therugbynetwork.com. We decided 2 years ago to start our own OTT platform because we were kind of tired of being the least sexy client on like ESPN's, where we were kind of buried with all the other sports. So we decided we'd start our own in partnership with a company called Rugby Pass that's the leader in this business around the world. And we asked them, what does success look like in the first year? And they said, if you could get 25,000 subscribers to jump on the Rugby Network, that's a pretty good start. And we got to that by week 7, and we ended the year at about 50,000, and now we're well over 115,000 subscribers on the Rugby Network. So all of our games can be watched there. We have a lot of shoulder programming. We're doing additional games. We're doing the USA Eagles. Big game tomorrow will be on the Rugby Network. So that's something that we own and operate, and we're not a partner with someone else on. This is a great team. You know, James, where's James? James, we've been talking for 3 years or so. You've got a great man in him. I've worked with Sam Harris. I've watched what he took one of our perennial teams that literally had their first year started 0-16 and turn them into a playoff contender 2 years in a row. Sam Harris is a legitimate, very good coach. And I'll brag on Sam. I've never had a coach do this to me. As soon as I was hired, he said, can I come up and visit with you? He goes, I got the rugby piece down pat, but I want to talk about the business. I want to talk about what your expectations of our team are. And then I also want to ask you, what can we do to help you grow this? So Sam's a real guy. It's a great hire for you. So with that, I'd like to present to the two main guys here, Matt, Phil, MLR Ball. Gentlemen, come on up. Matt, you first.
Thank you, George.
You are welcome. We'll look that way. We will move this way. And we'll move one more this way. Longest ball presentation. We're doing a second one, guys, if you want some of that footage.
Yeah. I'm not used to holding the ball this long.
All right. And our second one to Phil Groves. Come on up, Phil.
Yeah, Phil.
Thank you, Phil. Really looking first.
Cameras. Thanks, guys.
Thank you, George.
Thank you, George.
Peter.
Peter
Murray.
Peter, come on up. Thank you. Get the Rhino logo out there. There we go. Peter, you're up.
That's what we're doing.
Here we go.
Thanks so much, George. We started this journey more than 2 years ago. It's been a long journey, and we know the hard work is only just starting. I'm very proud to stand with this group and fly the flag for professional rugby in Chicago in the Midwest. But we take our responsibility to grow and develop the game very seriously moving forward. We'd like to announce that we'll be playing our home games at SeatGeek Stadium. Our new home will be in Bridgeview, which we're very excited about. We've got a fantastic relationship there. And we see this as a long-term solution for rugby in the Midwest. I'd like to open the floor for any questions and answers for myself or the panel.
So why don't you just explain why Chicago? You kind of touched on it at the beginning, but why choose to expand here to bring this team here?
It's a great question, and I think you can tell from my Chicago accent that I'm the perfect person to answer that. But I think it'd be great to hear from one of our like Chicago natives around why they think Chicago's so important.
Sure.
You don't mind coming up here.
Yeah.
Thanks, Phil.
I think so. The question was why Chicago?
Yeah.
Well, first of all, this is where we are. Our primary, focus is, we always believe Chicago and the Midwest, the greater Midwest, is the hotbed of rugby in America, is the largest market. We have the most clubs, most players, most colleges playing it, and we think we have the best fans. So it was a natural, when we were thinking about rugby that, why isn't it in Chicago already? It was really Matt and I's first question. How could this even be an opportunity? Because it should have been place number one, at least in our opinion. So as you can see from, a lot of the support we've already gotten, and I think the reaction to people that, and just the calls gotten from all around the Midwest, they're so excited to be here. It's a long time coming to be here, and it's a little overdue, and we're really excited to bring it here.
Yeah. So, yeah. And as Phil said, we may not be the sport number one or the team number one originally, but we'll be number one in the league when it comes to the end of the season, I'm sure, and we'll see you in that final, George.
Bold statement, guys.
A bold statement for a bold city. Any other questions?
I would say just for people who might not have had interactions with rugby before, for first time people who you're trying to entice in to watch, to get out to SeatGeek Stadium, all that stuff, what would you say to them about why rugby is something they should be watching and why they should be involved in this sport?
Again, I'd be happy to open this up to the panel, but I would say, look, rugby is a truly global game. It's a very unique game in the disciplines and unique values that the game has. I think it's a fantastic game for the youth coming through. Look, I think we talked a lot about the World Cup. It's a real big opportunity for us. We really think that that could be a platform for us to springboard the sport and continue to grow the sport. But, I mean, look, I come from, a as you can tell, a rugby-playing country, so I'd love to hear what Matt would like to think about that.
Sure. So, I unfortunately did not come from a rugby-playing country. I was terribly lucky to grow up in the Midwest here and started playing as a young man at 14 years old north of Indianapolis and played college rugby out in St. Louis and then spent the last 20 years here in Chicago playing rugby here in you know, really the best rugby town in America. And now I have the great pleasure of watching my children grow up playing rugby. And I think that, you know, the question for, you know, there's a lot of sports out there. Why is rugby the sport that we should be watching? Why is it the sport that will grow and is growing fastest in America? Really has to do with three things. Number one, it's incredibly exciting. It's a fantastic sport to watch. It's fast-paced. There's lots of action. Take all of your favorite aspects of football, the contact, basketball, the skills play, soccer, the continual motion and movement, hockey, the fast-paced, you know, back and forth. And it really has all of that. The second reason that I would tell anybody who's new to the game to sit down and watch is that, you know, it's been my experience, and I think the experience of a lot of the people, everybody sitting up here at the podium and a lot of the people in the room, that, you know, this is a sport that really will give back to you. It'll give you everything. If you give it a little bit of yourself to it, if you're lucky enough to play the game, you'll grow as a person, you'll grow as a teammate, and if you're in the stands, you're going to become part of that community. It's going to give back to you there. It's also a fantastic business, frankly. It gives back to the community from a business perspective. We're very proud to be partnered with Bridgeview and our great sponsors. And so, really, it's a sport that you get a lot more out of it, and it gives back a lot more than you put in. And, you know, the third piece, I think, the third big piece, hello, Ron. You know, the third big piece is just that, you know, this is an exciting opportunity, an exciting time. George touched on that, right? I mean, there's not a lot of sports where America is a sleeping giant. We're waking up to rugby. We have been for, some would say, 20, 30 years now, but with the World Cup coming, it really is a really exciting inflection point for American rugby and for sporting in general. And so, you know, Chicago is the right place for it. This is the right group of people. We have a fantastic coach. We've already drafted fantastic players. Our general manager is candidly the best in the world in any sport. So, you know, we're very, very excited, and we're going to watch this thing take off.
And you guys are practicing, and we're playing in Stadium.
That's correct.
Your home pitch. Where are you practicing?
Right now, we're looking at several different locations. We expect we'll be doing a substantial portion of practicing at SeatGeek, but as the weather, if this is Chicago, we do play in the spring, so as the weather and as availability and that sort of thing, and candidly, housing. We don't want our guys to have to travel, you know, an hour to get to training every day, so we're going to be moving around a little bit. One of the opportunities we have in this city is a lot of great partners and a lot of great locations that we can use for that sort of thing.
Great.
Yeah.
Thanks, James. Great words. Where do I sign up, Matt? I'm sold. And look, I think Matt touched on a really good point there. We talk about the sleeping giant now for about 30 years. I've been working in rugby in America for 10 years, and I'm kind of fed up of hearing, let's wake the sleeping giant. It's time that we did it. And I think at Chicago, we have an expectation and responsibility to be those people who have a significant impact on waking that giant as we look towards the World Cup. Any other questions?
Yes, we are late, so you guys got to give me a little brief.
Oh, wow. Okay, so welcome. Thank you for attending the launch of Chicago's first professional rugby team, Chicago. Sorry, did you have a question?
Are there any plans to integrate into youth programs here where rugby is concerned? I know there's some pretty robust programs here in Chicago.
Yeah, and we talked about, like, Chicago's got a fantastic tradition of youth rugby and a storied history around that. Absolutely, that's one of our, like, kind of key pillars around what we're building the organization, is to look at youth. I think it's how can we add rather than take anything away to begin with, and then how can we supplement what is already there. So obviously there's already a fantastic base of youth and high school rugby. We'd like to, first of all, support those and add resources to those current programs that are already up and running. And off the back of that, then try and identify some key areas, like inner city areas, where we can then go out and also start some new programs. We really think that rugby is a fantastic vehicle in order to, for not just social change, but also within, like, the school system. So yeah, we're really, really excited about that. That's going to be a long-term plan for us, and I think that it's not going to be something that changes overnight. But we're here for the long haul, and we plan to have an extensive outreach around those areas. Does anyone else want to add to that? Cool.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's go, Sam. Come on. Sam loves to answer questions.
No, I think I said two objectives, but if I had a third, the community piece would have been the third. I just didn't want to drag out this press conference, but I do think it's very important as a head coach of the team, to be an ambassador for the community piece. But it's so important to. There's so many clubs around the greater area of Chicago, and even, we're even a beacon for the Midwest now, not just Chicago. So I think it's our duty as the overarching club to align everybody and make sure that everybody's happy with how we are, branching out into the community, how we're communicating what we're doing, and making sure that everyone's kind of in the same boat and rowing in the same direction. And I think... we can also do that with coach education, and I can play a big role in that. But then also our players, as heroes to these little kids, can go out to the community and go and serve, everywhere around Chicago, and even further if we can manage it. But I think it's a huge piece of us as a club that we have to get right.
Yeah, and just to build on that, I love the term heroes. I think that we're a long way off from producing superstars at the moment. We can look to the future of that, but what we can do immediately is create heroes for those young players coming through that they can aspire to be like and that they want to come and really be part of. I think that what we can do as a smaller professional franchise is give a lot more access than some of the bigger teams can, whether that be in schools, around match day, and that match day experience for those young aspiring players. Does anyone have any question about season tickets?
Say, where normally can you buy them, James?
Well, it's funny you should say that, Matt. Thank you. Because we'd also like to take this moment to announce that we will be launching our season ticket sales today with a special promotional offer as founding season ticket members. And there's a chap called Andrew. Where are you, Andrew? He's waving his hand there to the camera. He will be selling season tickets for a fantastic value price of $200. For today, as a founding member, there'll be some exclusive access built around that as well, and that will be entitled you to obviously the 8 home games that we will play at SeatGeek Stadium, our new home. So, thank you all so much for coming out. This is obviously the first step of many as we look towards the future. We think we've worked hard to get to this point, but the hard work's really only beginning for us. We're excited to what we can take this and what Chicago Hounds Rugby could become. And we're really excited for you guys to be here and be part of that. And we hope that we can integrate you into our community moving forward. We'll be here for a while, so please come and introduce yourself. Say hi to myself or any of the guys here. If you have any questions, we'd love to answer them. It's been a real pleasure to be here, and up the Hounds.
Thank you.
All right, we are ramping up the news conference with the announcement of the new Major League Rugby franchise here in Chicago. This happened today in downtown Chicago, as you heard a number of members of the team, people who are associated with the team, discussing what has been going on. Obviously, the feed is now going out. A lot of people discussing some of the details about this new Major League Rugby team. Chicago's franchise will be the 12th in the league, and they will begin play in February of 2023. So for you rugby fans out there, we've seen a few of them in our Facebook comments. You'll be able to see Major League Rugby coming up here in the next few months. The team already has a head coach in Sam Harris, already has some players from an expansion draft that was held on November 10th. Going to go ahead and show you the logo for the Chicago Hounds. This was revealed at the news conference this morning. As you can see, the primary colors, green and blue. You see the 6-pointed stars. You heard that was a representation of Chicago's flag. So this is the logo for the Chicago Hounds. For those of you who are still watching on Facebook, tell me what you think about the logo, and we may feature your comments. We'll feature a couple of these at the end of the live stream. This was announced today, the Chicago Hounds logo, their colors, their official badge, and they will begin play coming up this year and next year, 2023, this winter. And we'll give you a couple details here about this new team. We just mentioned they are named the Hounds. They will have Sam Harris as their head coach. You heard from Sam during the news conference. They will begin play in 2023. And the schedule is already here for Chicago. Didn't have time to put it on the screen. We will also have this on WGNTV.com. So we'll take a look at the schedule. They are slated to have their first game February 18th against Old Glory DC. That one is on the road. And the club is also scheduled already to have their first home game. They've already put this one on the schedule. Going to get it over here. It was just announced maybe about 15 minutes ago. It will be Sunday, March 4th against the Utah Warriors. And as you may have heard during the news conference, the Chicago Hounds will call SeatGeek Stadium home. That was the former home of Chicago Fire FC and is occasionally when Soldier Field is busy. SeatGeek Stadium right now is the home of the Chicago Red Stars of the National Women's Soccer League. SeatGeek Stadium will be the home of the Chicago Hounds. Some other details that we can say, you heard from team officials that season tickets are already on sale. You can go to the Major League Rugby website to get more information on that. Again, Old Glory DC, that game will be on the road. That will be the Chicago Hounds' first game. That will be on Saturday, February 18th, the Hounds' first home match. SeatGeek Stadium, Sunday, March 4th, against the Utah Warriors. And one more time, here is the logo for Chicago's newest professional sports team, Chicago Hounds Rugby of Major League Rugby. This will go ahead and be the logo for the team. They will take the field in February of this year. Going to share a few details that were shared during the news conference. As you can imagine, a number of things coming out about the team. Few things I wanted to mention for you Chicago White Sox fans out there. Head coach Sam Harris said his favorite player was Frank Thomas. He also talked a lot about the outreach of rugby, trying to get the youth involved in the sport. As again, many times you heard during the news conference, they're trying to find ways to get more people involved in the sport and grow it to the levels that it's reached in a number of places internationally. Now, we heard from George Killebrew during the news conference. He said that this has been an effort of 3 years to get a franchise here to Chicago, and he hopes to have a major expansion leading up to two major events for the sport in the United States. That is the Rugby World Cup. The men's tournament is slated to be in the United States in 2031. The women's tournament is slated to be in the U.S. in 2033. He also mentioned Major League Soccer in this equation. Why? In 1994, the United States hosted the World Cup. Major League Soccer began a few years later and has now expanded themselves to right around 30 teams. George Killebrew, the commissioner of Major League Rugby, said that would be his goal, and he hopes that they might be able to do it before the men's and women's Rugby World Cup arrives in the United States in 2031 for the men and 2033 for the women. Now, I've been seeing a few of you chiming in with some comments here on Facebook. I'm going to go ahead and share those now. Here is Glenn. Let's see if this go ahead and works on the screen. Glenn saying he loves it. Thank you very much, Glenn, for tuning in to this edition of WGN News Now. We don't get to do a lot of sports ones on here, but excited to do it. Patty popping up on here saying very cool. Patty, thank you very much for watching our live stream today. Again, this live stream and the whole news conference will be available on WGNTV.com in a couple of minutes when we're done with this live stream. Robert chiming in here with a comment. Seems like he's a rugby fan. Rugby is awesome to watch nonstop. Robert, thank you very much for tuning into this news conference here. To learn more about the Chicago Hounds, the newest professional team in the city, Major League Rugby will start play in February of 2023. Looking down here a little bit, Joanne. What is the name of the team? Might as well put it up here. Joanne, thanks for tuning in. It is the Chicago Hounds. This, once again, is the logo to which they will have. Joanne, I'll take your comment down. For those of you who might be tuning in a little bit late and want to see the logo, as you can see, some Chicago representation there with the six-pointed star. The club announcing that pretty quickly after the news conference began. Of course, this was the main reason why they did hold it today, was to give the official details of the logo, the name, and where they're going to have their home venue. That will be SeatGeek Stadium. Going to keep going down the list here, see if we have any more comments. Okay. How about Tiffany? Tiffany coming in here with a comment a little earlier. I think it's exciting to bring a new sport to the city. My brother plays rugby when he was in high school. It's great to watch. I know a lot of people have said that. Had a chance to see rugby live maybe once or twice. A very unique sport, an exciting sport. So very curious to see how this franchise is going to take off once they get to Chicago. Taking along, let's see. Lisa, obviously, a couple of comments here. The Chicago Hounds, righteous. I like that description. Lisa, thank you very much for watching the news conference today here on WGN News Now for the Chicago Hounds, the new franchise in Major League Rugby. Thomas, this is totally awesome. A lot of people I've seen on here enjoy it. Rugby, of course, a new, big international sport trying to find a really strong footing here in the United States as well. So one more time before we wrap up the stream, we'll go ahead and give you the details of what is going on. Chicago Hounds Rugby will be the 12th franchise in Major League Rugby. They will begin play in February. Going to go ahead to their schedule real quick just to make sure I get it correct. February 18th. Against Old Glory DC. That will be on the road February 18th, 1 p.m. Central Time. That will be the first ever Chicago Hounds rugby match that will take place as they are a member of the league. How about the home opener? That one is going to be on Sunday, March 4th against the Utah Warriors. That is at SeatGeek Stadium. That will be the home of the franchise. Some basic information, as we mentioned, the team named the Hounds. That just came out today. Sam Harris is the head coach. Will begin play in February of 2023. SeatGeek Stadium is the home venue, and they are already selling season tickets. So if you're interested, go ahead and check out the website. And we're going to have all of this information coming up on the website at WGNTV.com. The story to which you may be watching this out of has just the basic information about today's announcement, but we'll be adding to that here in the next couple of minutes. If you wanted to watch the rest of the news conference, we will have that available on a recording on this same story. If you're watching on WGNTV.com, if you're on Facebook, it will be on the website. We'll have all the information, where they're playing, the schedule, all of that from today, and of course the full news conference if you should like to watch it again and see what other players and other people are saying about this new franchise in Chicago. But that's going to wrap it up here for this afternoon. I am Larry Hawley. Thank you very much for tuning in to this edition of a live news conference here on WGN News Now. The Chicago Hounds, the 12th franchise in Major League Rugby, coming to Chicago as they will play at SeatGeek Stadium in 2023 and begin play in February of next year. I'm Larry Hawley. Thank you so much for watching and have a wonderful day.